Hello student, welcome back to the polymerization chapter. I hope you are following my video. Let me start this class with a quote by Mahatma Gandhi. Live as if we die tomorrow, learn as if we to live forever. Means you should not, don't be afraid to live and try something new, because an investment in knowledge always pays the best interest. A small step towards learning make a big difference, because every journey start with a single step only. So let's start our lesson. We already learned about classification based on the source and also based on the structure. Now we will learn classification based on the mode of polymerization. This, what is mode of polymerization? How the polymers can also be classified on the basis of mode of polymerization into two subgroups, right? What are those two subgroups? Means addition polymers and condensation polymers. These are very two important one, addition polymers and condensation polymers. Let's know about what is meant by addition polymer. Addition polymer means, addition polymers are formed by repeated addition of monomer molecules possessing a double or triple bonds. Means for example, if you can, I already told you what is monomer, right? Monomer is the repeating unit of this polymer. This is the smaller unit, the smaller part of the polymer, and it is again repeating in the polymer. So these addition polymers are formed by the repeated addition of this monomer molecules possessing a double or triple bond. For example, if you consider this ethene molecule, there is a double bond, and the by the addition of these ethene molecule long chain, this ethene molecule, they are going add up to make a polymer called as a polyethene. If you consider this addition polymers, so the formation of polyethylene from ethene and polypropene from propene. However, the addition polymer formed by polymerization of a single monomer species are known as homopolymers. The, in that addition polymers only, there are two types. One, that is homopolymers and copolymers. What is homopolymer? Homopolymer in the sense, it contains only one monomer, single monomeric species. For example, if you consider this ethene is a single monomeric species, it is giving rise to polyethene. So this is called as an homopolymer. So if you consider this cope, what do you mean by copolymer? Copolymer in the sense, the polymer by addition of polymerization from two different monomers. Two different monomers are called, for example, if one monomer na use maadkondidre, that is called as an homopolymer. If two monomers, for example, if you consider here 1,3-butadiene is used and one more styrene is used. This giving rise to butadiene styrene copolymer it is. That is called as a Bunas. You may can, what is this name by Bunas, right? Buna here in the synonyms, Bu indicates that butadiene. And the Na is, what do you mean by this Na is? Na is nothing but this is what is the symbol of Na? Na is a sodium symbol, natrium, Latin word it is. The sodium is the polymerization reagent used here. That's why it contains the Bu means the butadiene, Na means here the sodium, and the S, whatever the S symbol, that is indicating that styrene. So total, so why, that's why it got that there are two different monomers are used. That's why it is called as an copolymers. So I hope you understand about this, what is the addition polymerization, and in that addition polymerization there are two types, homopolymers and the copolymers, that you just need the difference between the homopolymer and the copolymer. Homopolymer means there will be one monomer will be there, then copolymer means there will be two different monomers, means this 1,3-butadiene and styrene. Then coming to the next one, this condensation polymers. Then what is meant by condensation polymer? The condensation polymers are formed by repeated condensation reaction between two different bifunctional and trifunctional. What do you mean by bifunctional? I already told you. If suppose two functional groups, OH, OH, or a COOH, COOH, They like these two functional groups are present, that is called as a bifunctional. If three functional groups are present, that is called as an trifunctional monomeric units. In this polymerization reaction, by the elimination of a small molecule such as water, alcohol, hydrogen chloride, ammonia, like this, many small like this, by addition, by condensation polymerization means what? They are going to form a polymer, and there will be a elimination, addition, whatever the side product we are getting, that may be water, that may be alcohol, that may be ammonia, that such type of polymers are called as a condensation polymers. Examples are Dacron, if you nylon 66. Nylon 66 is formed by the condensation of this hexamethylene dimer and adipic acid. This, let me show you this diagram. Okay, this is what hexamethylene dimer and adipic acid. This is what called as a hexamethylene dimer, and this is adipic acid. Then you may consider why this is 6-6 name it is, right? 6-6, why? Because here the hexamethylene dimer, whatever. See, look at here. Here, how many functional groups are there? Two functional groups. Here also two functional, COOH, COOH, two functional groups are there. And why they got a 6-6 name? Because here also 6 carbons, and here also 6 carbons. That's why it is nylon 6-6. Why the nylon name, how it comes means, for example, if you consider cotton and rayon, these all the polymers, natural polymers, if you consider it. So the suffix is on only side, that's why this nylon name also nylon only. 40 first it was neuron, then that is converted into that as a nylon through pronunciation. Then coming to the these are the very important one, additional polymerization and a condensation polymerization. You must know the difference between the addition and a condensation polymerization. What is the difference between addition and a condensation polymerization? Let me tell you. See, very first one is generally involve one monomer, as we discussed in the at the beginning. That is, it if additional polymerization is, means it contains only one monomer. But in case of condensation polymerization, how many monomers are involved? Two monomers. And the polymerization takes place without the loss of any material. Means if you look at this one, ethene going to form a polyethene, means there is no side product are there. It takes place only without any loss. All the ethene molecules, the chain together to form a polyethene. But in case of condensation polymers, if you look at this one, there will be a water, ammonia, after the reaction there will be a side product, alcohol, HCl, like this side product will be there. So this is what the second difference between them. Then coming for the empirical form, then coming for this one, third one, empirical formula of the polymer is same as that of monomer. Empirical formula, you already know that. For example, if you consider C6H12O6, well known example, this is glucose. What is the empirical formula of this one? You can say that CH2O means proportion of the element present that one. For example, ethene, polyethene, this polymer, empirical formula will be same. But whereas in case of this condensation polymer, there will not be a empirical formula, will not be same, because it will be different. This is formed by hexamethylene dimer and adipic acid. The nylon 6-6 empirical formula will be different from that of the monomers. And these monomers usually don't contain any functional groups, as you already looked at ethene, it doesn't contain any functional groups. Whereas if you consider these condensation polymers, they have a two or three functional groups. Two functional groups, if you consider, there's a adipic acid contains the COOH functional groups, we already seen. And the next, what are the examples of this? Common examples of addition polymerization are polyethylene, PVC, polyvinyl chloride, polypropylene, polystyrene, Teflon, polyacrylate. These are the examples. No need to remember all those. At least you 2-3 are, you need to remember the examples of this additional polymerization and example of this condensation. A very well-known example is nylon 6-6 and a bakelite and a Dacron, urea, formaldehyde, resin and the terlene. These are all the examples of a condensation polymerization. Then this is a very important one. This is the difference between the condensation and the additional polymerization. Very important. You need to, they may ask you for the 4-mark question. You need to put a danger mark while reading. You can read it twice. So additional polymerization and the condensation polymerization. And also the definition, they may ask you for the addition polymerization and the condensation polymerization. So I will give you homework to what you mean by addition polymerization, what you mean with the condensation polymerization. Type it on the write on the comment box and post it. What do you mean by addition polymerization and the condensation polymerization? For 2 marks question, you need to answer this one. Let me move to the next classification. We already learned this one. What do you mean by there is a based on the mode of polymerization? We divided the polymers into additional polymerization and condensation polymerization. In addition polymerization only itself, it contains two types, homo polymers and the copolymers, and the difference between that one. Then coming for the classification based on the molecular forces, right? Classification based on the molecular forces. Large number of polymer application in different fields depend on the unique mechanical properties like tensile strength. Tensile strength, you already know that. What do you mean by the resistance of a material to breaking under the tension, or to break breaking under the force or a tension? If that is called as a because the every material, they have a different tensile strength and elasticity. This already you come, elasticity and the toughness, you already learn in a physics. That is elasticity means what? The ability of an object to resume back the normal shape after being stretched. When you stretch a rubber and it will back to that original position, that ability is called as an elasticity. And also toughness, you know, energy absorbed to fracture is called as an toughness. Depending upon these molecular forces, we divide the polymers into different types. These mechanical properties are intermolecular forces. Maybe yavde force irbodu, which are the intermolecular forces? Van der Waal force irbodu, very weak force of attraction it is, and a hydrogen bond between the intermolecular forces present in a polymer. These and if polymer alli itara different force in the present agi, that brings the change in the mechanical strength and tensile strength, elasticity, toughness. Depending upon that one, we are going to divide the or a make a classification of these polymers. These forces also bind the polymer chains under this category. The polymers are classified into 4 subgroups. Let me see what are these 4 subgroups. First one is elastomer, and the second one is fibers, and the third one is thermoplastic polymers and thermosetting polymers. So if we will look at this one by one, this elastomers, right? So I already told you, what do you mean by that elasticity? You already know these are rubber like solid with the elastic properties. In these elastomeric polymers, the polymer chains are held together by weakest intermolecular force, for like van der Waal force. And they don't contain any hydrogen bond like this. They will be like this. They will be having a weakest intermolecular force. Weak intermolecular force in the enagirate, connect agirate. Then these weak bonding forces permit polymer to be stretched. For andre ee weak bonding force in the enmadabodu, we can easily stretch those one. If there is a weak bonding force, and we can easily stretch those into. So this few cross linked are also introduced between the chain, which help the polymer to retract its original position. So this original position after the force has been released. So you already seen that vulcanized rubber if you stress that one, very weak force they make apart, and after that, after leaving that force, it comes back to the original position. Examples for that one is Buna, I already told you. What do you mean by Buna and Buna? Yes, and N is nothing but a nitrile, and neoprene is an example. I already shown the picture this one, and the remaining fibers and the thermoplastic polymers will teach you in the next video. So I hope you understand this concept, what you mean by this based on the mode of polymerization, addition polymers and the condensation polymers, and what is this by elastomers also. So one more question, write it on the comment box, what are elastomers, and give example for elastomers. We'll meet in the next video. And read it well and practice well.